Hey everybody, John V here from Phone Arena. You're watching our in-depth video review of the Huawei Impulse 4G. It's available right now through AT&T. It's an affordable mid-range handset sporting a $30 on-contract price point. You get features like a WVGA display, Android 2.2 Froyo, and 4G HSPA Plus connectivity with it. The Impulse 4G is actually AT&T's version of the Huawei Adios X5, which we previewed back in January. Nothing has really changed with its design, but for a mid-range handset, especially from Huawei's camp, we're very excited about it just because it feels like a solid handset. You have this soft touch coating in the back, which gives it a clean look. You have this rounded top and bottom edges. Overall, it's well-balanced, a conventional-looking approach, but significantly better than other Huawei devices like the T-Mobile Comet. The Impulse 4G features a 3.8-inch WVGA display, so that's 480 by 800 pixels. Obviously, it's good enough to make out fine details such as text here. Colors are decent. They're not as saturated compared to Super AMOLED Plus panels, but more than acceptable. Unfortunately, though, its viewing angles aren't the best. You could see it fading very quickly. Even though the Android capacitive buttons are placed further away from the edge here, we still notice in our experience using the handset accidentally pressing them. Sadly, for a device that's branded as a 4G-enabled handset, it lacks a front-facing camera. With its volume rocker, it has a good shape and size, and has a good response too when you press it down. Meanwhile, on top edge of the handset, you have the 3.5mm headset jack, dedicated power button, so a little bit kind of flat-looking and difficult to make out the finger. On its opposite side, we just find the micro-USB port for data and charging connectivity, and you also have the microphone. And finally, in the rear, we have the 5-megapixel autofocus camera with the LED flash. It's kind of raised from the surrounding area. You have also the speakerphone right next to it. Removing the back cover, you just gotta slide it off and reveals access to the battery, the SIM card slot, the micro SD card slot. It comes preloaded with a 2GB card in there. Unfortunately, there's no confirmation in regards to the processor in use with the Impulse 4G, but seeing that it has close ties to the Adios X5, it should be running an 800MHz Qualcomm MSM7230 processor. And you can tell it's decent, it's not the most fluid or responsive. You could tell even with a live wallpaper, it still has a little bit of a hesitance to its operation, but overall, with a static wallpaper, it's a little bit better. Unfortunately, the Impulse 4G is running the stock Android 2.2 Froyo experience, which is already behind the curve compared to some of the gingerbread devices out there in the market. Still though, you have all the personalization aspects with Android, you have a lot of useful widgets, the app panel's laid out in that usual 3D Rolodex view, but everything else is pretty much the same as any other Android 2.2 Froyo device out there. Even though it's branded as a 4G-enabled device, we're not all that impressed with the speeds offered by the HSPA Plus-enabled Impulse 4G. You can tell here some of the download-upload speeds, and pretty much in the same realms of a 3G-enabled smartphone, as much as 3.4 down and 1.5 up. As far as just the usual web browsing experience, it's decent. It's not the smoothest out there, you could tell. It's a little bit jerky with its movement here. Pinch gestures are somewhat smooth here, and you do get flash support, which is nice. The music player interface is nothing different. It's a stock experience. You have the you have the album cover and also on-screen controls. With the audio quality, it's actually really strong, almost deafening, and at the loudest volume setting, you kind of get a hint that it's kind of straining as well. When it comes to video watching, it's a little bit of a challenge on the Impulse 4G, just because the video we have here is encoded in MPEG-4, 800x40 resolution, WVGA. You can tell it's straining to just load smoothly, not that much on the detail side, but it's very evident that it's chopping its playback. Sadly though, the Impulse 4G's 5-megapixel autofocus camera fails to impress us just because in outdoor conditions, it just looks very muddy and grainy too. Color is a little bit bland as well. Indoors, it just tends to put this blue tinge to the shots with the LED flash, and there's a lot of digital noise in low lighting conditions. At the same time, the handset 720p video recording is pretty poor looking, tell you the truth. It's extremely muddy looking, details are almost gone, colors are bland, and the audio recording is very muffled in tone. The only bright point is the fact that it shoots at a rate of 28 frames per second. Call quality is less than agreeable to our taste, just because with the earpiece, it's not the strongest volume output out there, making it very difficult to hear our callers, and doesn't help when voices sound hollow in tone. On the other end of the line, our callers did say our voices sound a little bit on the choppy side, and when we switch to a speakerphone, volume output is strong, but again, voices do sound choppy. Signal strength with the Impulse 4G is pretty good. In high coverage areas, it's able to get a good amount of bars, and in our time testing it, it didn't drop any phone calls. Equally as appealing is the handset's battery life. We were able to get more than a solid days of usage on heavy usage actually consisting of texting, web surfing, and occasional phone call. So the Impulse 4G might not be the handset to appease hardcore Android users out there, but for anyone looking to get into the smartphone realm, for $30 on contract, you really can't complain about the Impulse 4G. You get a decent amount of specs, mid-range specs actually, large display, you have high definition video capture, 4G, HSPA plus connectivity. So you have a lot of stuff in tow with the handset. Even though its performance might not be the best when it comes to things like taking videos or photos and even the actual performance of the platform here. It's still nevertheless an entry-level device that won't hit your pockets that much. So if you'd like to learn more about the Impulse 4G for AT&T, you can check out our website, phonearena.com. Thanks for watching, guys.